Olá, bem-vindos à Igreja no Mundo, o programa da Fundação AIS aqui na TV Canção Nova. Hoje vamos ter o nosso programa todo ele dedicado a um país, a Serra Leoa. Serra Leoa é um país africano que viveu um período grande de guerra civil e que desde então tem estado sempre mergulhado num clima de pobreza extrema, de violência nas ruas. E é precisamente por causa da violência nas ruas, na capital, Freetown, que um punhado de sacerdotes ligados ao Dom Bosco, à comunidade de Dom Bosco, tem estado a procurar retirar jovens que estão nas ruas, que vivem em situação de extrema pobreza e extrema fragilidade. Vamos conhecer essa história.
One night, I meet up some gang there, gangster there. I began phone. I'm a pocket switch, yeah, phone. They meet me, they round up me, pull me phone, beat me. Now I see, can see. See me is aid. Now they beat me, call number score, line 323. From there, Father George, go there, go pick me. I don't get no fumble, I go call. I don't get nobody number, now only number score. So I decide for call them.
It was impossible to recognize whom he was. And they told me it's one of your boys, it's one of Don Bosco, former boys. I cannot recognize him because his face was disfigured, no? Cuts, broken arm, and cuts all over her body, bleeding. And I brought him to emergency hospital. I remember so clearly, no? The nurse looked me with resignation. He told me, you again, no? He said, Father, forget about these boys, and you are wasting your money, you are wasting your time. Let them die on the street, that is what they deserve. And I was shocked at what the nurse told me, no? And I told me, no, but you don't understand who we are, no? We are Don Bosco. It's not that these boys are evil, it's that nobody stood in front of them, looked at their eyes and told them, there is such a potential of good in you, no? He was looking at me and I fixed my eyes on him and I felt such pity for him, no? Such compassion and I knew what I was about to tell him. What do you want to do when you recover? Would you like to go back to the streets or you want to take in your hands the second chance, second opportunity that God is giving you? They speak about 2,500 children living, working, and sleeping on the streets in Freetown. And the reasons are multiple. I may say the first one is the situation of extreme poverty, even misery, in which families are living. Some of them, for example, they don't receive from the parents the money they need to pay the school fees. What they do? Well, my parents do not care for me, they don't pay my school fees. I go to the streets, I will work, I will collect money. I will go back to the school. Others because of work, because the proper child labor. The parents, they use them instead of sending them to school. They ask them to go out to the street to sell peanuts, to sell cakes, or to sell whatever. Ending of the Ebola outbreak, certainly this created a new generation of orphans. You know that in Guinea, Liberia, Sierra Leone, 8,000 children lost both parents or one of them. Some situations of injustice have moved many, many Ebola orphans to go to the street.
How are you? I'm moving. Who's this now?
Best of my friends. Don't cast.
Who's that?
Cast.
But what's the movement now this morning?
I don't talk about the street.
Who's that?
Up.
You don't sleep, you don't get out of the tree. So you don't survive this morning. So who's that you go for now?
Ah, they go move to uniform. So I'm ready to punch this.
Wow, so with all this debt you need to do some money to get for letting you help yourself for those schools?
Yes.
Wow. How are you, Tony? So what's happening? What's the idea doing? How much this week?
I don't know.
That's it. How much you go get from this school?
I go get 30,000 pounds.
35 pounds. Wow. All for iron. So then the pull and one on inside the bag in the way and so. Inside the bag. But what do you expect from this?
I go 23,000.
23,000. Wow.
Machine.
Several of them are still those who were rebels, soldier boys during the war, because they experience the consequences of war and they use violence, they suffer violence, but also they exercise violence upon others. And several of them who are sick and very weak and very slim, they have no future on the streets. Their future is to grow on the streets until they die because of malaria and other sicknesses and hunger and malnutrition. And obviously those who suffer most are the children because they are the most vulnerable ones. Sometimes I think I would like to write a Sierra Leonean Via Crucis, no? Because when I see the Stations of the Cross, I say, Jesus today is there on the streets, he's suffering, no? When I see some of these boys and these girls and their stories, I said, it's not that Jesus is in heaven looking at them, how they are suffering. Jesus is in them, no? He is suffering in them.
The streets, let me see, throughout my life, from 13 years of age to 16 years, I was on the streets. 17 years of age, I met one social worker by the name of Mr. Momo Kagbo. He met me on the street. We talked together. He explained about Don Bosco. One of my friends, I remember, at PZ, he met me at night. He said, my friend, I went to Don Bosco yesterday. I ate a lot. They talked to me. And I said, okay, let me go and see. Mr. Momo has the patience to come again on the street. One time, two times, three times.
Joe Conte, he's the coordinator of the rehabilitation program, and it is wonderful. And you see somebody who has been on the streets, he knows the laws of the streets, the problems of the streets. He can understand the boys better. He has the capacity to accompany these children to go out of hell into a transformed life, because he had been already through that.
So, Abbas, yeah, on force, a to company, eh? How to call Ntiago? They used to call me Uncle Joe. Sometimes I do call the boys. I talk to them. Hey, man, it's okay. I know how you feel. When we recruit, Halia, there are some cases, maybe some boys will just take 1 week. They want to go again on the streets because they have been used to this marijuana, used to drugs, used to gambling, but here, there is nothing like that. So I want to go, you come to, I said, ah, my friend, calm down. I know, I used to take this before. It was not easy for me. I said, so please calm down. I know the situation. If you want to become a good somebody in life, forget about the street.
Whenever we bring boys, the first month, I tell you, here we have the street within Fambul, because any small provocation is immediately start to fight, to impose your personality on others through violence by kicking and hitting and shouting and stabbing. They may take the toothbrush and try to stab somebody. And, well, for us, it's a matter of patience. And I always tell them, look, if you have a problem, you don't solve the problems fighting, imposing yourself by force, by strength. Here, if you have a problem, we sit down, we dialogue. We learn to accept the other as he is. No? We learn to forgive. We learn to speak, to have tolerance with others. And do you think that it's correct the way that you react, the way that you... Do you think that it's good to take a wood and to hit Brother Julius? Do you think that it's correct? So you wanted to destroy the baby football?
You come here, pizza, no more. Very good. Can you come?
Where are the boys?
Yes. How are you?
Hello, where are the boys?
Here? Yes, yes.
Here? Okay. There was an incident today. Are you aware? We have talked. And he has something to tell you. What do you want to tell them? Sorry. And? What do you say?
Forgive me.
And then forgive me for waiting.
So? So what do you say?
Forgive me.
You cannot play in Don Bosco the rules of the street. How you settle matters? By kicking others, by hitting with a stone, with a glass, with a stick? How you settle problems in life?
By sitting down and discuss the problem.
By sitting down and discussing the problem. That is what I am asking you. When you go back home, you think that you are going to resolve problems with a stick? Kicking others, hitting others with stones or with a glass? Are you going to solve problems like this? No, it's not the way. But you see, he's also able to recognize he has made a mistake. So he's apologizing. I am sorry. Forgive me. That is the way in any family. If somebody has made a mistake, what do we do?
Forgive.
We forgive. Don Bosco knew that if you want to transform even the hardest boy through loving kindness, you can transform his heart. It's a strength that comes from God, living in his presence, trying to be united with him, seeing him in any person who is coming to you, trying to discover his face, no? I am a follower of Christ, I am in love with him, and all my life, I have experienced that God loves me so deeply, so much. No? And maybe that is why he called me to be a Salesian, to be a priest, and to give the sacraments, and to be an instrument of his love and mercy, no, towards children and young people. I understand Pope Francis, for example, he says, don't make projects, pastoral projects, sitting at a desk, at a table. Make projects from the peripheries, no? Go and stay with the poor, live with the poor. And here in Sierra Leone, we do that. Sometimes when I feel tired in the office and writing, answering emails, and I go down to the playground and I sit with them or I start to play with them and I feel happy, no? Because I think that the streets of the town, for us Salesians, are like a theological place, no? So we meet Jesus in the chapel, we have adoration, prayer, Eucharist every day, and we experience God there, no? But when you go to the streets, there is no difference. No? The same Jesus every day I have in me, my hands, no? It's the same Jesus that I found on the streets, no? And with different faces. Who is the best player of the world?
Messi.
From which country?
Argentina.
Very good. And what is the best team in the world?
Barça.
Very good. And who plays in Barça?
Messi.
And from which country is Messi?
Argentina.
Very good. You are excellent. Thank you. Be careful with this. How is this boy? He's the most popular boy of Angola, it's true, he says.
Yes.
He's the most popular boy of Angola?
Yes.
And all girls are after him, he says? So what are the major problems of Angola?
Major problem. Our major problem is that we don't have enough toilets.
We have some about 400 rooms.
Ah.
In Angola. Some rooms have more than 10 to 16 people.
In one room, 16 people.
Yeah.
Steven. Sila.
Tula.
And Tula. Very good. Okay. Buonanotte, good night. See you tomorrow.
Buenas
Take
noches.
Care. Bye bye. Buenas noches.
Have a nice evening.
Perfect Spanish.
Have a
nice
evening.
Bye.
Bye.
No, we are not waiting for them to come here. We go out to the streets regularly, sometimes within 1 month, every night to the streets, and we try to see where they live and they work and they sleep. We go there, we smell poverty. We see the rubbish on the streets. We see the rats on the streets, you know, the same rats that are biting the feet of the children in the night when they are sleeping in the market areas. And this moves your heart, you know? You cannot remain indifferent. And I can imagine, if I feel compassion, what is the heart of Jesus, you know, today for these children? God has no hands, no? We are the hands of God. God has no eyes to exercise his mercy. We are the eyes of God, and we are trying to go to the streets and to look with the eyes of Jesus to discover, no? If Jesus today walked the streets of Freetown, no? To whom he would go? Where clearly he would go to search for this voice. How long he has been on the streets also?
Yes.
Eh?
Since the time of about 3 years.
3 years also.
Dollar.
So he is not going to school and... You see, this is a case that we should follow, no?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Wait a bit.
Hey.
Come here. Joe,
yes.
Speak. Maybe this boy, really, sit here. Sit here. So sit there. So I think a bit why he's here, what are the possibilities?
Rosa y Tomás.
Is your brother?
Yes.
How old is he?
Oui, papa. Como y cana una chonga su.
8 years? He's 8 years old. Do you have any relative who is a point of reference for you? So he has never gone to school.
He has
lost during the Ebola outbreak. He lost mother and father. He's from Mile 91, I think, no?
Yeah.
And they have come to Freetown, and since then they have been living on the streets. He has never gone to school.
So, but you look for Golden Bosco, eh?
Yeah.
If I invite you tomorrow, you go?
Yeah.
You sure?
I don't want that tomorrow.
Maybe you can bring him to Golden Bosco tomorrow?
Wait, ask for people, Julia. I'll keep for you something. Wait, you ready?
Bobo. Good.
Thank you.
How many people are sleeping out, more or less? Have
more than 80.
More than 80. Any children from Angola sleeping out?
No. Only the parents.
Only the parents.
And the maids.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You also go to rest, eh?
Yeah.
Hello, Michael? Yes. Thank you for calling, eh? Yes. Yes. The pictures you saw on WhatsApp was yesterday night. Around 7:30, we were finishing the prayer, the adoration in the chapel, and then they were shouting, and one house started to burn, and it seems that it was electrical fault or somebody who left a fire unattended. It was too fast, no? More or less in 1 hour and a half, in 2 hours, everything practically got burned. You see here, everything is iron sheets and wood and cartoons, and everything was impossible. It was impossible to stop. No lives were lost, thanks God. And we are giving thanks to God. Material things. Well, firemen came, but you know the situation in Sierra Leone. First of all, two fire bombs came, and one was without water, the other was faulty. So the fire was expanding very, very fast. It was a very windy night. Some young men, even our boys from Angola, they tried to stop the fire, but was impossible. Yes. We had to open the doors of Don Bosco, obviously. Well, it was a bit chaotic at the beginning. Now we are the day after. Nothing remains. They lost absolutely everything because there was no time to rescue any belongings, no? All the children were sitting just in front of Don Bosco Fambul, waiting to come in, and there were some mothers with infants, lactating babies and breastfeeding babies. So we took them all. At the moment, I calculate we have inside Fambul 270 to 300 people. Apart from that, we have 28 street kids, there are 24 girls, 58 Ebola orphans, 225 inmates at Padimba prison, young people who are there in the correctional center, plus the school. Yes, all our former kids from Don Bosco Fambul, there are more or less 470 who are receiving the school kids, more or less 1,000 people at the moment. The children are very, very happy. They are sleeping on mattresses. They're eating 3 meals a day. You have to consider that many of them, they were eating in Angola once a day. We had to buy everything. Later on, some people came offering some rice and some beans, some mattresses. One member of the parliament came to make some pictures, and he gave 2 bags of rice. So that is all what we received from the government at the moment. How long? We do not know. You know how things are. This is an emergency, it's a crisis intervention. We are not afraid. We know that we are in the hands of God. We trust in the providence. When things are needed for the children, the Lord always provides, no? And all what we receive goes for the children. And I don't worry. I never worry. We know for whom we are working. We are working for Jesus. We are trying to see Him in everybody who is coming to us. Okay, thank you. Keep on praying for us, eh? And whatever help you can offer, we will be very grateful. God bless you. Bye bye.
Agora ficámos a conhecer um pouco melhor a realidade da Sierra Leone, nomeadamente na sua capital, Freetown, e o trabalho desenvolvido pelos padres Dom Bosco junto dos jovens que vivem nas ruas, que são vítimas da violência que existe nas ruas desta capital africana. Chegamos ao fim do nosso programa. Despeço-me com amizade. Até à próxima semana, se Deus quiser.